I'm going to show you how you can use the BPS for the cheapest amount possible. So the idea is to avoid paying for a BPS panel. So that means that you can just pay for your BPS plan and you're good to go. So I'm going to show you this with Hostinger's BPS. I'm going to show you an open source BPS manager, which is called Histia. So I'm going to show you how to install the whole thing and how you can install a WordPress site on it. So let's get started right now. Welcome, SaaS Masters. My name is George. And like I said, I'm going to show you how to install your WordPress site on a BPS without having to pay for a BPS manager. So what BPS plan am I'm using? I'm using Hostinger, and I'm going to use this one, which is hosting, BPS hosting, and I'm going to use this one, the KBM2, which is the most popular one. It's $799 a month. And let me show you, you can get an extra discount aside from that price. So if I go ahead, add it to cart, this is what we can select. So first of all, you can select 1 month and 12 months. Obviously 12 months is much better. Plus the renewal price in 12 months is also better. Now, like I said, there's an extra discount coupon code. So click on have a coupon, say SaaS Master, and apply it. You can see it's $99.95 and now it's $86. So it's much cheaper using that coupon code. So I'll provide the link and the coupon code in the description. Now let's get into the good stuff, the tutorial. Okay. So like I said, I'm going to show you how to set this up without having to pay for a BPS manager. So if you're using shared hosting, you don't need a manager. It comes along with your, this in case Hostinger, it's hPanel. If you're using something else, it could be CyberPanel or cPanel. So it comes along bundled with it. But when you buy a BPS, it doesn't come along bundled with it. It's additional. So it's like you only buy the BPS, they provide the hosting for it, and you have to use a BPS manager. But in this case, we're gonna use a free one, okay? So you're gonna set up your first BPS. You're gonna start now. You're gonna select the location you want to use your BPS. And in my case, United States is the one I'm gonna select because that's the closest where the most of my clients are gonna actually view the website, okay? And then you got three options. So OS with control panel, plain OS, and applications. We're gonna use OS with control panel. So let me select, and you have two main options here, but we're gonna choose different control panel. There's several panels available. Be aware, like I said, I'm going to show you a free BPS panel. If you use Plesk, if you use cPanel, etc., those will cost you a month-to-month basis aside from the BPS that you purchased at Hostinger, okay? So we're gonna use Histia or Hestia CP. Let's go ahead and select it. This is open source. Let's go ahead and continue. I'm gonna set a password for my panel. Here we go, let's continue. We're not gonna save it for now. We're also going to need a secure root password. You can reset this later on, so don't worry about it. Let me write something here. Okay, let's continue. Here we go. So it's United States, Ubuntu with Histia CP, and this is the host name. Let's go ahead and finish setup. Be aware that you can later change OS in case you change your mind, and don't worry about that, okay? Okay, we're not gonna wait for this one to finish. We're gonna jump into my panel where I have Histia installed already. So let me go into my account. Here we go. Let me go down here. And this one is the one we're installing right now. So it's pending. And this is the one I have ready. So let me go ahead and manage this one. Here we go. And you can see the current OS for this one is Ubuntu and it's Histia CP. That's what I'm using. All right. Now, how can I jump into my Histia panel where I'm going to install my WordPress site? I mean, that's the whole thing and the whole point about this. Okay. So let's go into operating system. And this is where you're going to get your login details. So let's log into the URL. Okay, here we go. I actually have one site here for test, but we're gonna install one right now, okay? So how do we log in? Let me actually log out. Here we go. So again, let me go here. Here's the link that it's gonna take me to. I need to log in. Here's the admin. And then I need to log in. The password is the one that you've selected over here. You can reset the panel password over here, which I've done previously. So let me do it again. Here we go. I am now in the admin panel. Now, the first thing I recommend that you create is a username, okay? So that's where you're going to install the websites. Because you can see here, we don't have amount of domains. You can see that they're limited, but that's because the history is crazy in that section, okay? So let's add a new user. And for this, I'm gonna name it test2. Contact name, test2. The email, I'll use my email. Password, I'm gonna do something really simple for now. And here we go. I'm gonna save this. There we go. It's been created. So let's go ahead and log out. Let's go ahead and log in again. So it's test2, next. And the password I've created, which is really simple. Let's go ahead and log in. And here we go. You can see now we have unlimited websites, unlimited DNS, unlimited email. Everything's unlimited. I don't know why Hestia does that, but basically Hestia doesn't want you to use the admin user for that, I guess. Okay, so how do we add a domain? So first of all, we're going to add a domain. We're going to call this Hostinger at Loofer.com. That's one of my domains. Here we go. And I'm going to create this subdomain for this case, okay? And it's telling me that I need to point it to this IP address. This IP address is the one on your BPS panel. So it's this one. So it knows how to connect. Now, in my case, I don't have my domain at Hostinger. I have it in Cloudflare. So over here on Cloudflare, what I'm going to do is point it to that IP address. So I'm going to add a record. It's going to be an A record. And it's going to be for, here we go, Hostinger. You can see now it's hostinger.anilufer.com. Okay. And it's going to be to this IP address. I'm going to save it. Here we go. Let me jump into incognito mode to show you this. Okay, so hostinger.anilufer.com. Hit enter. Okay, it's just a success. There's no WordPress site there. Okay, so let's click away from here. Let's go back into our Hestia panel. Let's go ahead and save it. There we go. It has been created successfully. Okay. Go back. So now we're going to click on this one and we're going to do a quick install app. Okay, this is where we're going to install WordPress. Let's go click on it. You have all these available options, but in this case we're going to do WordPress. Let's go ahead and set up. Let's set the name for this, and I'll say test to the WordPress account username. I'll set test to also the account email. I'll use my email password for this. Again, I'm going to keep it simple. Okay, it's going to be installed in the root folder. The PHP version, I'm going to select the most recent one, which is 8.2. Database create, yes. We can also set the database name, user, and password. We're going to keep it in autopilot, but I would recommend that you do this manually and you save these details, okay? Let's go ahead and save this. And right now it's doing the process. It's going to install WordPress, so let's give it a couple of minutes. There we go. WordPress is installed successfully. So let's go back. Okay, let's go into our web section. Here we go. Remember, it's Hostinger at anilufer.com. Let's go ahead and check it out. Let's go ahead and visit it. And boom, we have a WordPress site. Now, how do you go to your login credentials? It's by default. There we go. Let's go / /wp/admin. Enter. Here we go. Remember, it's test 2. And then we got an easy password, 1234. Let's go ahead and log in. And boom, here we are. We have our test 2 website installed successfully using Hostinger's BPS and Hestia's BPS manager. So now all you have to do is work along with the SSL. In this case, Cloudflare has the SSL, but you can go ahead and do it from here, from Hestia also. You have your DNS settings, your mail, your database, your cron, and your backups all here with this open source system from Hestia. So this is a great way that you can avoid paying for a BPS manager. So let me know what you think about this, if Hestia is a good option, or if you want to go for the paid version of cPanel or Server Avatar or Plesk, or what is your take on this one. But that is how you're going to install WordPress on an open source BPS manager without having to pay extra. Well, I thank you all for watching. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that little bell notification. That's a wrap.